What's up guys, Charles here. Amidst all the talk about the best GPUs for gaming, and the best CPUs to pair with them, it's common for us to sideline the intricacies of memory. You might keep things simple by picking one of the best RAM for gaming, but there's more to it than just choosing that we need DDR4 and DDR5 RAM. Leaving aside aspects like the memory die used in your RAM, you still need to consider the frequency and latency of the memory kit you're buying. Depending on your use case, either of these factors can matter more than the other. This is the spec that most people use to identify a memory kit. While the best DDR5 RAM for gaming can have frequencies of up to 8,000 MTs, you can also consider DDR4 RAM for gaming. But how exactly does frequency affect your RAM's performance? RAM frequency, the need for speed? Well, you can consider frequency or transfer rate as the speed at which data is transferred from your storage to your memory. It's measured in megatransfers per second, HEMDs. The faster the rated frequency of your RAM kit, the snappier your system will feel. Though at some point you may not feel it, memory frequency has the most tangible impact on gaming performance and the day-to-day performance of your PC. The previous gen DDR4 memory kits ended up with 3,000 to 3,600 MDs, the sweet spot for most systems, while for the newer DDR5 memory kits, 6,000 to 6,400 MDs can be considered the optimum RAM frequency for most applications. And hey everyone, I've noticed that a lot of you have been tuning in regularly to watch our content, which is awesome. But did you know that a large portion of our viewers aren't subscribed yet? It's true. So, if you're enjoying what you see, and you find yourself coming back for more, why not hit that subscribe button? It's a small action that makes a huge difference for us. Plus, it ensures you won't miss out on any of our upcoming videos. And remember, stay with us till the end of the video, because we always save some of the best content for last. Trust me, you won't want to miss it. RAM latency speed isn't everything. It's true that memory frequency has a bigger impact on performance, in most cases, than latency. But you can't ignore the latter altogether. Memory latency is the time it takes for your RAM to respond to a request. Latency is composed of various factors, but we'll limit this discussion to CAD latency, which is denoted by the CL or C number in your memory specs. You can check your kit's CAD latency by looking at the memory tab in CPU-Z. Under timings, you can find it next to CAD hash latency, CL. This number denotes the number of clock cycles your RAM needs to access a set of data. The actual latency in nanoseconds is calculated by the formula latency ns equal CL2000/data rate.
Data rate is simply the rated speed of your memory kit. 3600 or 6000 or 6400 MDs. RAM latency matters more in applications like video editing and rendering. For gaming, latency doesn't have a whole lot of impact on your FPS. RAM frequency versus latency, what does the data say? To illustrate the performance impact of frequency versus latency, we ran a few CPU benchmarks using CPU-Z, Geekbench, and IE64 Extreme. These tests measured the CPU performance as we switched between kits of different frequencies and also between different latencies on the same kit. You can see the single thread, 1 Tesla, and multi-thread scores, ND, for CPU-Z and Geekbench for our 4,800 MDs and 6,400 MDs kits. The IE64 Extreme results show the read and write performance and the associated latency of the kits at different XMP settings. You can clearly see the impact of memory frequency and latency on the memory test score in IE64 Extreme. When going from a 4,800 MDs to a 6,400 MDs kit at the same latency, there's a 37 to 40% increase in the read and write score. On the other hand, decreasing the latency from CL40 to CL32 for the same frequency results in a relatively lower 30% increase in the read and write score. This demonstrates the bigger impact that frequency has on memory performance than CAD latency. The Geekbench CPU test shows a change only in the multi-thread score when moving between kits, and only a frequency increase is able to move the score significantly. The latency improvement doesn't really affect the scores much. Do consider subscribing for all the latest content on the gaming, and as always, see you in the next one. Peace out.